In this video, I am going to explain anatomy of lumbar plexus. Lumbar plexus is kind of a bundle of many nerves. You see, there are many nerves running like this. Yes, there are many nerves from lumbar spine. In first part, I will describe the basic anatomy of lumbar plexus. And on the second part, I will explain relationship with muscles. Okay? So first part, I would like to try to be as simple as possible. Today, I am going to explain this one, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Okay, I will explain 6 nerves. The most superior one is this one. This is iliohypogastric. The second one is this one, ilioinguinal. The superior one is iliohypogastric. The inferior one is ilioinguinal. It's a little bit confusing, isn't it? It's same kind of the letters, iliohypogastric or ilioinguinal. Oh my gosh, which one is superior? Which one is inferior? How to remember is the second part, iliohypogastric or ilioinguinal. Which one is more superior? Is it gastric? Gastro means the stomach, or inguinal? Inguinal or gastric, which is on the superior part in the human body, which is hypogastric. So the superior one is iliohypogastric. The second one, the inferior one, is ilioinguinal. It's kind of a simple way to remember. Okay, the third one is this one, genital femoral nerve. Genital femoral. It's simple. Genital, it goes to genital area and femoral area. Simple enough. 1, 2, 3. The fourth one is this one, lateral femoral cutaneous. It's a little bit long name, I know. It's on the lateral part. It's going to lateral part of the femoral, femur, and cutaneous. Cutaneous means a sensory nerve which takes information from skin. So this is the outside, the femur, and takes information from skin. So it's simple enough, right? And next one is this one. Let's jump on to the inferior one. This is fifth one. This is obturator nerve. This nerve mainly innervates adductor muscles of the thigh. So this goes to the inside of the thigh, I mean the medial part of the thigh, okay? Obturator nerve. And this one, this is the biggest nerve among lumbar plexus. Sixth one, this is femoral nerve. Goes to, you know, femur, especially anterior part of the femur. This is the biggest nerve. You see other kind of a minor nerves like these branches, but in this video, I will not describe these tiny nerves, okay? So, there are mainly 6 nerves. 1, iliohypogastric, ilioinguinal, genital femoral, lateral femoral cutaneous, obturator, and femoral nerve. But, you know, it's kind of hard to remember the all 6 nerves in order from superior to inferior. How do I remember? Okay, the first one is this one, iliohypogastric. The first letter is I, ilioinguinal, I, genital femoral, G, the lateral femoral cutaneous, L, and let's jump on to the fifth one, obturator, O, and sixth one is F. Okay, this is how I remember, okay? I twice get laid on Friday. You know, it's funny, but it's best way to remember. I learned this from my anatomy class. I will say that again. I twice get laid on Friday. Yay, now you know the sequence of lumbar plexus. So this is first part. I basically explained you a basic anatomy of lumbar plexus. On next part, I will describe relationship with these nerves and muscle. Okay, now you see many nerves and muscles like this. on the right side, this is this person's right side. On the right side, you see many nerves. Do you remember? Iliohypogastric or ilioinguinal, the femoral nerve, genital femoral, you know, the lumbar plexus on this side. But if you look this side, the left side, you see muscles. What is this one? This guy. This is psoas. Very important core and hip muscle. So imagine psoas runs like this on the right side. Don't you notice something? The lumbar plexus appears from posterior from psoas, because you don't see the lumbar plexus on this side on the on top of psoas, right? You see lumbar plexus, you know, appearing from posterior to psoas. What does it mean? So if psoas gets tight, maybe hyperactivity or tight psoas, that can irritate lumbar plexus. Or if nerve is irritated, I don't know what happens, maybe car accident or too much activity or anything. If nerves got irritated, that can affect psoas. That makes sense, right? And there are many other core muscles relationship with lumbar plexus. What are they? They are like, you know, transverse abdominis or quadratus lumborum, or maybe iliacus here. Many deep core muscles are related with lumbar plexus. These are very, very important structure. Say psoas got, you know, tight. Maybe some people might think, yeah, you use hip joint too much, or you use less hip mobility, hip movement, that's why your psoas is tight. Maybe yes, but that tightness can be from lumbar plexus or tight core muscles in relationship to psoas muscle. This relationship is very, very important. So I hope you learned something from this video. If you liked today's video, please like, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.